First off, I want to thank everybody for coming. Can everybody hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
I want to thank everybody for coming. And then I tell you to be seated, which already sat down, so it's cool. And something I would like to do that I don't always do is, I noticed two of you brought her up, so who presents her? I never say give because I'm a father of six daughters. Nobody owns my daughters.
So I'll present her.
Who presents her? You both can, actually.
That's okay.
Now, this is a party. Love stuff. Hold hands. 12-inch rule. No PDA. Okay. So here's the part I love the most. This is my favorite. Okay. Let's get the technicalities out of the way. Does anybody have any objections? Time's up. Had your chance. Thanks a lot. That's my favorite part. Thank goodness no one's ever said anything. But I do have people in the audience that are willing to take them out if anybody ever does. So it's all right. So before we start, I'm going to say a quick prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for bringing us all here today for this wonderful day between Jon and Lori. We ask that you bless this union, that you allow all of us here to be a part of this every day, forever for them, to be there whenever they need us. And we just ask that you just make this the best day in their lives ever. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, before we start, I'd like to share a quick story, okay? This is for you guys. It's a story of a child, okay? And there was a tree. People may have heard it. And the tree loved the child. Every day the child would swing from its branches and sleep in its shade. Nothing could have made the tree happier. As the child grew older, more was needed from the tree. The child asked for the money. The tree gave it to us so he could sell it. Later in life, the child grew, needed a home. The tree gave its branches to build the house. Years later, the child said life was sad and wanted something more, and the tree gave its trunk to build himself a boat. Late in life, the child was old in years and returned to the tree one last time. The tree was now only a stump, but the tree loved the fact that the child was there, and he would have given all that was left, and all he had left was to give its stump for the child to rest upon. The tree was always at its happiest when it gave what the child needed. That's unconditional love. Jon and Lori, I've watched you two over the past month or so. That's you. That's both of you. It's unconditional love. I see it. You know, I'm sure you do too, and I'm sure others do around you, but I see it. And that's the greatest thing. But no one is an expert on the subject of love and marriage. Most of us know when we're the happiest, when we're not focused upon ourselves but others. But love means sacrifice to make others happy. But in doing so, we make ourselves happy. Sometimes it's the little things, Jon, like doing the dishes when it's not your turn. And sometimes it's the big things, like doing the dishes when it's not your turn. Okay? If you can put each other first, your relationship will be as strong as it is today. You might ask, what does that have to do with him leaving socks on the floor or toothpaste in the sink? Let me just say, it won't make your laundry any cleaner. It won't make your smile any brighter, but it will make your task more fulfilling if you put each other first. Hold each other's hands. Wait for it, though. This ain't for okay. Jon and Lori, life is not going to be easy, but honestly, nothing in life that's easy is worth having. I've had the gift of watching you both lately, and from what I've seen, you both already realize what a gift you've been to each other. Now comes the hardest part in life, living it together. Are each of you ready to do that? That's the question that you'll ask yourself every single day from now on. If you are, then the actual hardest part is really over. The rest of the life is just fine-tuning for each other. Always remember, what works today may not work tomorrow, but it may work next year. Or may not. You are both going to have good days. You're both going to have bad days. Just remember that no one ever, ever remembers the bad days. But they treasure the good days that they have and look forward to the next one. And the key word there is together. In 1 Corinthians 13, it talks about love is patient, love is kind, love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irreparable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things. Love believes all things. Love hopes all things. Love endures all things. And now faith, hope, and love abide, and the greatest of these is love. Jon and Lori, may this love that you bring into this relationship have its presence touch all those with whom you come in contact with. Your lives will be shared in love that can hold more than each of you will ever know. Love is the reason that you chose this day to begin your life together. Love is the reason that you gave each other with all your hearts for the good of each other. Love is the reason you are becoming as one. One in hope, one in believing, one in sharing. Yes, that means half yourself is now hers. Okay, now we're going to do, Lori's chosen and Jon have chosen to do a sand ceremony. Symbolize the pouring of these two individual containers of sand, which represents each of you and all that you were, all that you are, and all that you'll ever be. As these two containers of sand are poured into the third container, the individual containers of sand will be joined together as one. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into the individual containers, the same will be said of your life together. Chaplains have been saying that the ring is a perfect circle. Biggest lie ever presented. It's nothing perfect. Nothing is perfect. If man made this, it'll never be perfect. The closest we'll get is if a machine made it, and even then, there's always an imperfection. The both of you will never be perfect. If there was two of her, John, one would be better than the other. The one that you have now would be better than the other one. Still wouldn't be perfect. If life was perfect, it would be the most boring thing that you'd have to live with each day. It's the imperfections that the two of you have that make your life imperfect. Marriage is not perfect. It never will be. It's the unperfect that makes us so different, what draws us to each other. So what I want you to do for the rest of your life is embrace the imperfect instead of looking for the perfect. And each day, I promise you, will be better than the last. Now, let's do this, okay? John, will you take a listen? Repeat after me. I, John, take you, Lori, to be my wife.
I, John, take you, Lori, to be my wife.
My partner in life.
Partner in life.
My one true love.
My one true love.
I will cherish our marriage.
I will cherish our marriage.
And love you more each day.
Love you more each day.
Than I did the day before.
Than I did the day before.
I will laugh with you.
I will laugh.
And cry with you.
Cry.
I will love you faithfully through good times.
Love you faithfully through good times.
And bad times.
And bad times.
Regardless of the obstacles.
Regardless of the obstacles.
We may face together.
Yeah.
I give you my hand.
I give you my hand.
My heart.
My heart.
And my love.
And my heart.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Your turn.
I, Lori, take you, John.
To be my husband,
my
partner in life, my one true love. I will cherish our marriage and love you more each day than I did the day before. I will laugh with you and cry with you. I will love you faithfully through good times, bad times,
regardless of the obstacles
we may face together.
I will
give you my hand.
I will give you my hand.
My heart.
My heart.
And my love.
And my love.
From this day forward. For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
Let's face this. I'm going to charge each of you. Before I pronounce a man and wife, I would like to add this. No other human ties more tender, no other vows more sacred than the ones we've heard today. In the face of chaos of every day, every wedding is a celebration for the potential of goodness. It is a celebration of our ability to live in love and peace, and is a gift to all of us here. As John and Lori prepare to join their lives, it is important to understand that each of us in this room has played a place in shaping the characters of these two, and will play a vital role in their continuing lives. I ask all of you to be a blessing to this couple, now and forever. Support and strengthen this marriage by holding them up with your love. Thank you all for